to Candy Crush Facebook.
Hi.
Yeah, what's up?
Not a lot, it's just, have you noticed anything weird going on?
Nothing too strange, why?
Well, it's just, the telephone lines have been cut, our phones have been sabotaged, in various ways, and our dog is hanging by its neck from a tree outside.
We had a dog?
Yeah, it was a surprise Christmas present. Surprise.
Well, now that you mention it, someone did mail us this copy of Farming Simulator.
Yeah, I wonder who that could have been.
Yeah.
Ah.
Well, this is just excellent.
Oh, don't worry. Backup generator should kick in soon.
Hey!
Haha! Oh, convenient!
Fucking. I think I heard something. Well, that's unsettling.
Yeah. Well, look. The most important thing is that we approach this rationally.
Right.
Yeah.
Rationally.
I said no! Heh, that's right. Wait a second.
Hello!
Ah! Oh shit!
Oh, oh, oh.
What the hell is going on in here?
I think Glenn broke my nose apparently.
He snuck up on me!
It was a surprise!
What happened to ringing the fucking doorbell? I was afraid I was going to wake everyone up!
You killed our dog!
No, I didn't! He was clinically depressed! I held his paw!
Right, okay, whatever, just... What are you doing here? Glenn, check his pocket.
No.
Really?
Yes! wanted to watch the other one, but you decided that we should watch Abraham Lincoln versus Vampires.
Whatever. I guess there's nothing else to do. Oh,
where the hell is Chris anyway?
Open Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Op, 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 op.
Sorry guys, I need to go get my suit coat. Anyways, hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Dragon Car. We have Glenn here, we have Chris here, and we have Nick here drinking... What is
Cava.
That name? Cava. Yeah, it's very good.
Don't get him started.
But yes, we all took it upon ourselves to watch Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter on what is New Year's Eve.
Yeah, this is the movie we chose for New Year, guys.
Yes. And,
I wanted to watch Blast Fighter.
Of course he did.
Of course he does.
Everyone wanted to watch Blast Fighter.
So I think...
I've already seen this.
Yeah, he's already watched this film before.
Yeah, I kind of did it against Daryl's will.
I was out and then he just decided, oh, I'm just going to take this.
I work at a paintball site, so I don't get much work special towards the end of the year. Daryl, on the other hand, works at Tesco because, I'd hate to... You know, spoil the illusion if you thought he was making money off these videos.
Occasionally.
But he works at Tesco, so he has more regular jobs. So he buggered off one day, so I nicked his room and watched Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter.
Didn't you also watch Armageddon?
Yeah, I watched Armageddon as well, so I can undoubtedly say that was the worst of the two. But
I don't really know... this movie is like... It takes itself far too seriously.
I really don't have much to say about this movie, but I hated it, so I'm just going to sit here and drink Cava for the entire room. Because really, I don't have much to say about this other than something, something, how dare you take the South and make it about vampires versus humans instead of racist versus white people.
Yeah,
The Civil War is such an...
thing about is that if it, you know, even if it still was about the Civil War, you know, if it had taken itself less seriously and had fun with it.
The thing is, it was actually the most enjoyable bit was before the Civil War. The Civil War bits, it's all boring because he's all brooding like, I've turned this country into war and blah blah blah.
The movie's too immature to realize it's immature.
Yeah, it takes itself far too seriously, and also
or too mature.
It focuses.
It doesn't realize it's.
It's trying to be mature with an immature subject.
Yeah,
it tries too hard to be
grand and visual. You know what I mean? Like it has all these. Has a lot of slow motion effects and a lot of terrible
a lot of dramatic, passionate
I know what you mean.
We know what you mean. It's that overly sort of dramatic and serious shit.
And of course,
accompanied by Hans Zimmer style music. Is it Hans Zimmer?
It's not even Hans Zimmer, no.
No, it's just got that sort of chugging music.
Another thing that this movie did was it abused the whole like 3D thing, because I get the feeling that the movie was actually shot in 3D.
No,
I don't think
so. It's
Timur Bekmambetov, who's the guy.
Well, you mean the revolutionary director, Tim?
The visionary director, Timur Bekmambetov. He directed. He directed Wanted. He directed Night Watch and Day Watch.
Never seen.
And he's basically the Russian equivalent of Michael Bay, essentially.
But he works for Hollywood.
So in other words, he's a Russian twat.
I'd still rather watch this than Bad Boys 2.
I think he's Russian. I think he is. Yeah. Anyways, you would like to say.
Talk about another
subject, bar Abraham Lincoln Vampire.
We were discussing.
Well, I'll say one more thing. Yeah. It's another one. You just see like you see the budget on screen. You know, just how wasted it was. Just because CGI is expensive doesn't mean it's worth using.
The scene with the horses.
Just skip the rest of the movie. Just watch that. Just watch it. It's brilliant.
No, just skip the entire movie.
No, you watch the movie with horses and scream war horse.
No, I'd just rather go watch War Horse in the theatre.
We were discussing that the perfect guy could do it. I mean, you were saying apparently the novel is meant to be quite funny and
I think it takes itself more silly, but I watched this before, I haven't read the novel.
This has kind of soured me on it, but I probably should. Also, the fact that the guy who wrote both the novel and this film also wrote the Dark Shadows movie, which is a terrible flick, probably even worse than this, to be honest. But you were saying you had a better idea.
Yeah, yeah, well, it's a vague idea though. What would it be like? I don't know. Abe's gonna end up in a swamp somehow.
Yeah.
In New Orleans, because New Orleans is cool.
Yeah.
And he basically just fights every famous monster.
Well, you know what? We're gonna be watching.
Oh, it's the asylums.
It's the asylum, right?
Yeah.
We're gonna be watching the asylums, Abraham Lincoln versus Zombies, which apparently is. Better, anyway, my film's probably better, but
yeah, it's basically him just going there. He's kind of like Link, because he's got tons of weapons on him, and he's also boxing, and he basically beats the shit out of Frankenstein, swamp monsters,
swamp thing, Dracula, the mummy.
Yeah, Dracula, mummy. All these foreign monsters are here for no reason.
What was that one?
Yokai from Japan.
Reptilicus.
The human vapor.
You gotta get Reptilicus on the go.
Reptilicus, yeah.
This is the thing. I'm just beating the shit out of all of them,
and then you go. It's basically just a day in his life, and he goes, "No, I'm off to be president now."
Yeah, and then he goes, "Watch me off the sunset, right?"
Now, okay, I'm gonna try and wrap this all up. Okay, so, but basically, my overall view is. Don't bother.
You just said that the horror scene was worth watching.
Well, yeah,
that
was
one scene.
Well,
no. When it's time to party, we will party hard.
Okay, it's a friggin' new year coming up.
You ever had white wine before?
No.
Well, maybe it's years.
Right, okay, well, I'll see what
it's nice!
Nah, check the bloke out, he's awesome.
He's like the most lonely man on you.
His crotch is on fire. That's professionalism right there. His crotch is on fire and yet he continues to play.
Oh, my dad's watching Jules Bond.
That's nothing.
He's watching Jules Bond.
There's always a tradition you watch Mon's leg.
Well, my dad's tradition is to watch Mon's leg.
It's Mon's leg for God.
He swaps between the two.
Yeah, the Scottish tradition of ejaculating a fucking steel ball into the air. That's proper Scottish tradition. Speaking of Scottish tradition, Jackie Glenn.
3, 2, 1. Yay!
Happy New Year, you pricks.
Happy New Year, Glenn. Yeah, have an adequate New Year, Nick, and you too, Chris.
Oh, that's
okay.
Weird.
But yay! Wow, women in the army?
Talking.
Loads of fireworks and
yay!
Yay! I'm still alive.
Y2K's 14 years late.
If you're gonna watch Abe Lincoln Vampire Hunter, or just skip to the bit with the horses.
That's it, just watch the bit with the horses.